So I have a little quiz for you because I know that this is Friday morning and thanks to be here. And you see like that people cannot complain, oh yes, I got a talk scheduled Friday. I have two talks scheduled Friday. So a quiz, I don't know if you know this guy. So, and next question. Do you think that he practiced football? Yes. So another really complex question. Do you know this guy? Do you think that he practiced tennis? Yeah. A more complex one. Do you know this woman? So this is a really well-known pianist. Do you think that she practiced piano? So. Did you see the pattern? It's a bit complex. I know this is Friday morning. So, the question behind the scene, this is, how do we practice skills? So what you see is that from that perspective, we can program. That's the first thing. If you want to be good in programming, maybe you should program. I don't know. The point after this is, how do you make sure that you get feedback? Because if you write shitty programs, okay, you will have written shitty programs and you do not learn. So, and what we see, I don't know how many of you are doing real code review in your daily practice or weekly practice, but this is not the majority. Let's say that this is a little club of people. So after you have code katas, how many people are doing code katas? You should do that. This is super fun. Do you know what is a code kata? Ask Google. No, but seriously, you know, we are in 2020, so you can ask Google code katas and they explain everything and then you do it. But we do that and this is super fun, especially in full TDD. And now that we have Dr. Test, so Nicola is not here anymore, Dr. TDD, we will already be able to use that. So you can participate to sprints. So how many of you participate to sprints? Ah, way, yes. Yes, that's cool. So I always love pair programming because I try to learn something from the other one. And then in this talk, I would say participate to open source because that sounds cool. But, yes, you are a poor noob. So, and the world is so complex. So, and you see, each time I see two students, but yes, you can do something, and then I said, but I'm a noob. Huh? The point is that we are all learners. Don't tell me that you know everything because your ego does not fit the room, so that would be a problem. We could not move, you know? So I'm always learning. I'm always in this attitude that I want to learn something. So the solutions are often some clicks away. So for me, what I do, and I suggest that people do the same, this is I take any opportunity to read code. I read even closed pull requests that I didn't close, you know? That's an opportunity. I said, I want to know what's changed in this code? Ah, they did that. Ah, okay. You should also take opportunity to contribute because like that you are more in an active mode. And contributing is easy. Repeat after me. Contributing is easy. After a couple of thousand times, you will see. You don't have to think when you say it. So let's look at that seriously. This is a potential list, and then we will go over that. Read and answer newbie question. Participate to a wiki. Review bug description entries. Review bug fixes, write test for bug entries, improve test coverage, improve comments. You know, they were not really, I didn't say fix a bug in that list. So newbie question. You know, I was step back and when I started to learn Smalltalk, when I was at University of Bern, I discovered Smalltalk by accident. And then I went to see my boss and I said, so I want to teach it, and I knew nothing, you know, nearly nothing. I said, okay, I have 1 year to be good, and then after I leave. Of course, I stayed 10 years there and things like that. But I went to see Oscar, and I said, okay, I love this stuff, I know it approximately, but I will teach it like that. I'm sure that I force myself to be precise. He told me, okay, put my name on your lecture and you can do it. That's like that, because like that he could remove one lecture from his stack and I could do one lecture. And I learned a lot because people ask me questions like, the initialize on the class side, what is the difference with the class side and the instance side? And I didn't know. You're like, oh shit, I don't know. And then you think, and then he said, I should do it. I should know it because I am the teacher, so. And then after, I knew it. You know, this is just that easy. And then when I didn't know, I just looked for the answer. And you should try and do it. You know, I discussed with Sven. At some point, he told me that he was trying to answer all the kinds of questions that people would ask in the Faro mailing list as a way to learn. And I tried to do that. You know, a guy asked a question. I said, okay, I have 5 minutes to answer because I am the master. Yes. Okay, and if I fail, I wait that somebody else answer the question and I learn. You see? So that this is that complex. You can participate on Discord and you can read it, you know, just read it. Okay, this is a, yes, I took a random screenshot. So you can just read it. You know, sometimes I just read the database channel because I don't understand anything on databases. So like that, I can see a bit what people are doing. Or you can even answer question. You know the stuff, let's answer it. This is a contribution to a community. So by the way, this is a parenthesis. You know, square brackets are parentheses in this talk. Huh? How did we meet with Marcus? Yeah, I know, you know. How did we meet? In fact, we reviewed squid bug issues. So he was one guy in Germany that I never met, and I was one guy in Switzerland, and I was looking at his comment and I said, hey, I like the comment that he put on the bug entries. And then after he started to commit and I said, oh, I review his commits because they were cool. And then after I said, hey, why don't you want to come to visit us? You know, just like that. So bug entry, wonderful stuff. You go, you take one bug. You said, can I understand it? No. Is it clear? If this is clear and you don't understand it, then you will see I have a solution for you after. But if you don't understand it and this is unclear, then ask for clarification. On which OS, on which Faro version, on which, you know, people don't know what is to report a bug. Huh? We don't teach it, so of course they don't know it, but even me and even some professional developers don't know how to write bug reports. Can you repeat the problem that the guy described? Because sometimes, I don't know, sometimes you fucked up your system and then you report something and then you ask, is it only me? Or, and then if you said, yes, I can repeat it consistently, this is always happening like that, then this is cool because we know that we can address it. This is a valuable information. You can contribute, this is that difficult. So you see something else that you can do. You can say, oh yes, there is a problem. Can I write a test on this problem? It's a little bit more challenging. Huh? And if the contributor provide a test, is it sound? You know, once I remember, there was a bug in the arithmetic logic in Squeak when I started. I could not understand, and I still cannot understand anything about numbers. But, you know, there was a test where the guy said, okay, if I take one, I bit shift 200 times in that direction, and I bit shift 200 times in that direction, guess what? I should get the same number. And I said, oh, yes, I can understand this test. That's a good test. So you see, there is a difference between the test specification and the solution. So at least we can do these kinds of things. What you can also do, you know, on Discord, I was looking at the discussion between Dale and Alistair. If I want to learn something, then I look at the discussion. Ah, yes, okay, okay. And then at the end of the reading, I learned something. This is cool. So now, the key question of the universe. What if you do not know? this is difficult to be lame. We all know it, but why if you do not understand? You know what you do? Easy, you drop it and you go to the next one. Life is so difficult, you know? And I discussed with Guichet because Guichet was telling to me that when he started to try to contribute to Faro, you know, he read a bug entry, I don't understand. Next, I don't understand. He spent a day not understanding bug issues. Okay, then you do it the next day. No, but seriously, this is not more difficult than that. Huh? What you can also do, you can also read the test to learn. And then as soon as you read something and you said, oh, I don't like it, it sucks, then this means that you learn something because you educate your taste to say, oh, I don't know what is the solution, but that implementation looks really suspicious. You know, like there is something seriously strange here. And the test, they can be improved. You know, you can take a test and say, oh, this test does not cover it well. This is strange. It didn't cover that case. Oh, I can either create a new test. You saw the test that Pablo showed you for the UI testing. This is something that I learned this year. You know, I was with the crowd believing that UI testing were difficult. That would be cool to have them, but they are too difficult. And then Guichet arrived and said, okay, look, I wrote some stupid test and said, oh, wow, I love them. So we can write those kinds of tests. So improve test coverage, you know? This is the same. You can say, oh, this method is not covered. Oh, let's try to do it. Because we are not telling you change and provide a much nicer implementation that has much better complexity and memory in blah, blah, blah. No. Specify the output. This is something that we can all do. You see something else that I did that is, I'm super, super cool, in fact. You see this method, all ranges of substrings. I had no clue what it was. You know, I said like, oh, wow, what is it? What is it? And then you write a comment like that. A, B, C, D, E, F, A, B, C, D. What is the range of C, D? Oh, now I can understand. Wow, what a contribution. Yes, I know I'm cool. Huh? And when I'm dead, the Friday evening usually, I take a class and I look, I said, oh, what is this API? Especially the kernel ones, because now in Faro 8, these things are crawled automatically by Dr. Test, and then they are turned into tests. So I know that if I write something wrong, and you, what you saw is that Julien showed that we have bugs because before we didn't add Dr. Test. So you test it, but you don't have an automated test, so after you get errors. But you can do these kinds of things. Free side effect. And this is especially for everybody, in fact. When you contribute to an open source Smalltalk system, you increase your visibility of headhunters. That's as simple as that. So either you work for a company that will never be bought by another one and crashed, where they said, no, it's super cool what you have done. We love what you have done, but we should rewrite it in technology Z. And maybe you don't want. So the point is how do you invest on your own future? And open source, you know, sometimes I have the impression that people believe that open source, yeah, you know, this is these kids, they play and this is fun, but I prefer my protected project because like that I have the insurance that it will work and also that I cannot change it myself. So open source is not that, you know, open source protects you also from assholes. You know, because if you open source the stuff and then your company get bought by a mega things that do not like you and try to crush you, then you said, bye. Maybe you will not sell the product, but at least your knowledge is not trapped in a box and put on the trash can. So I think that, yes, you know what I mean. And for example, Cyril told me, oh yes, I'm often contacted by headhunters. They ask me if I want to get a job. And what they do, they go on GitHub, they look how the guy commits. So this is a guy that knows how to communicate, you know, sharing his code. You know, my dead company hire a guy I was against, but you never win. You do not always win. I could never see a lines of code of this guy. And I had big warnings in my head, like poop, poop, poop. What is the quality of this guy? We are hiring a new CTO and I never saw a lines of code of this guy. I felt bad during a lot of time, but I was the only one against. And then at the end, I had, unfortunately, 10,000 times, I was 10,000 times more right. So everything fucked up. So you see, so this is this transparent. See, I can see and can go and check your code. It can be bad, by the way, but I can do it. Then something else, because this is something also that people often forget. Everything that you do today has an impact of your own tomorrow, you know? That you want it or not, this is like that. Just a couple of examples. You know, sometimes when we are discussing at lunch, we said, oh yes, you know, I would really like to work with this guy that is in the community. And this is fun because around the table, we are always on the same wavelength. Said, oh yes. So for example, Igor, in fact, Igor was just committing to Squeak and Faro and things like that. And we always like the things that he was doing. And then after we got a position and we said, don't you want the position? And he came. This is the same for Esteban, by the way. So everything that you do has an impact. So if you can control it, this is much nicer. And if you can shine it a bit, okay. So I think I will finish this talk by a personal note. You see, sometimes for me, what I want to learn, this is rarely in books. Because that's like that, or they are. You know, last time I started to write a book on, to read a book on a virtual machine, I don't know what, and the guy start to teach me Pascal-like, I don't know what language, during 100 pages, and then after analysis, and I was saying like, I don't want to spend all these chapters to do all your exercises because I want to understand the end. Or at some point, I wanted to follow a lecture at in a university in Germany. They said, yes, you should come, but this is 6 months. Who has 6 months now to go to take a lecture? Not me. So, unfortunately. So the key point is, how do I learn things? And especially the things that I don't know and that people didn't rewrite. You see, for example, like what Guichet was presenting on the and Pablo with the thread stuff. Oh, yes. How do I learn those kinds of things? And that's why what I'm doing, I'm trying to take really any opportunity to read code. In fact, when we started Faro, and this is not to control things, this is to learn. I decided, oh, I want to read all the code because I want to. So when you do a pull request, usually I will go and read it. Even if I don't comment it, I will read it because like that, okay. And then I ask a question. I said, oh, why? And then. So for me, this is my own way to learn stuff. Okay, this is the end of my super great talk.